Hi guys, today I want to show you a way how to make a self-portrait. I'm doing this drawing in a classical academic way. I have my bachelor and master degree in fine art. I'm a practitioner artist and an art teacher. So I decided to share with you some art lesson and I hope you can enjoy it. Here's three pencils in my hand. There are HB, 2B, and 6B. In fact, my HB pencil happened to be a little darker, but this doesn't affect the way of my work. I'm starting with the main composition. What do I mean when I say composition? As an example, when we take a picture of something with our camera or with the phone, in the beginning we choose in the screen what kind of image we will have. So, we already pick the size that our object would be, not too small and not too big. The same deal with the drawing. It should be the right size of the head. Here is a small secret. You can measure the size of your parts with a pencil. I put my finger on the pencil and hold it with my arm length forward to the head. Attach my nail to it and measure. Compare one part with another. For example, I put a pencil measure to the chin. Of course, I'm not touching the person or the reflection of me. And then I compare the size from the tip of the chin to the nose with the size of the nose or with the size of a forehead. In the classical way, they are the same size. But it's a classical way. In ordinary way, we are all very different. Maybe your model is a person with a long nose or with large forehead. And it's cool. This is about proportions. People are unique and their proportions make them themselves. So right proportions on your portrait or self-portrait can give you a likeness. You should start drawing with really light lines. For this, buy a harder pencil, so HB is fine. Don't push your pencil too much, that you can easily use the eraser and change your drawing if you need to. One more important comment. In the beginning, there are maybe a question about how it's better to sit to make a self-portrait. There is advice to sit down so that your front part will be on light part and the side part in the shadow. It just gives you an easy way to make a realistic three-dimensional portrait. When we make classical drawing, it is important to start drawing from the general shapes, the rounded shape of the head, the shape of the egg. In it we find the place of the eyebrows, nose, eyes and lips. And we remember our eyes in the middle of our face. Usually the ear is located in the gap between the eyebrows and the lower part of our nose. A common mistake that beginners make is they can start their drawing with picture of their eyes or lips or even start it with eyelashes. Classic drawing requires us to build our drawing step by step, from general shapes to smaller details. When I made this video, I had the idea that you would see me in the mirror in a slightly turned way how I've seen myself. But when eventually I watched this video in the end, I realized that I mostly reflected frontally in the mirror. So I added on the video a picture that shows you how I'm seeing myself while I'm doing this drawing. In my video, I additionally add images with construction lines. What we can see. First, there are two parts of the head, the front and side part. The middle line on the front part helps us to check ourselves. Whether the nose or eyes or lips have been moved in a wrong way in our drawings. We also have horizontal construction lines. The eye line is approximately in the middle of the head. We should draw horizontal lines with understanding about perspective in our mind, meaning that they are not completely parallel in our drawing, but convert slightly at the end farthest from us. And perspective is an important part of drawing process, and maybe in future I can make one more video about it. Construction lines are used as a skeleton, as a base, which helps us to draw a portrait. When we know how to use the line of construction, we can eventually give them up, having them just in our mind. I don't use them so much in this drawing, but I have them in my mind. I had a lot of time when I was drawing step by step while I was a student, so I used to drawing with construction lines. I can also give you a little advice. If you really want to learn, you can print in the beginning a picture of a person that you will portrait, or it will be you. And after it, you can draw these construction lines on your print. This way you will be better understand what you are doing when you will draw. Maybe someone can have a question. How to draw yourself if you are moving in a process? Really, just don't pay attention to this. Artists go through it. Sorry, it's how it is. In fact, there is a trick. It is always easy to draw yourself from a ready picture. In general, it is easier to draw a portrait from a picture because the picture is already has a still image. But if you're looking for a classical version of a creation of portrait, you're doing it from the model. If you have an exam in art school, or if you go to some art class, you have to draw it from the real model. So I show you exactly this way. The way of drawing which I offer you now may be named as the Russian academic art. It's not really about Russia, and I'm not from Russia, but it's the same way how we are accustomed to say Russian ballet. In classical drawing, at the beginning can be a requirement to make a drawing with hard pencils. So it was this way in my student life. But soft pencil give you liveliness and softness, and now I decide to use it too. It's easy, better and brighter to make some dark spots as a shadow or your hair with softer pencil. What is the advantage of drawing a self-portrait as a training? When a person wants to become an artist, this person should practice a lot. Being the model for yourself, easiest way you always have your beauty in your mirror. And also it's really interesting to know yourself in the mirror, to know how to do drawing of yourself. When you're doing your shading, try put it on the way of surface. Or you also can have a line and continue your shading parallel to this line. You can also apply a cross shading.
Thank you.
I initially showed you three pencils. If you take a training portrait, you should work with harder pencil in the beginning. It's easy. But if you want to add some liveness and emphasize some contrast, soft pencil will help you to do this. When we make hair, it is an important part. Remember that we also working with a 3D form. So when you put some shade, make it like a form. You can also use the shading on the form almost from the start of your drawing. Just do it in the beginning very light. It can help you to see your drawing as a 3D object when you put your shading. I drew this self-portrait for a little over that 1 hour. When I came to the end of the video, I had the desire to finish something else at this my work. But my goal was to create a drawing from the start to the end and complete the video in a short time. That's why I don't spend extra time trying to make my work completely perfect for me. In this case, the work is complete. I could add something else, but I especially leave it as it is. so you can see all the way from start to finish. I hope this video can be useful for you. Leave your questions in comments. Have a wonderful creative time. See you next.